Is Jordan back again like I never left? And right now, I'm about to react to Certified Lover Boy by
Drake.
You had us waiting a whole year. Nah, actually, you had us waiting a few months. You said January, you broke your leg. You claim that's why you pushed back the album. I already know that's probably not why, but it's okay because it's finally here. Although, you give us this album cover. I get it. It's part of like the joke of Drake's album cover is terrible. Same week we get a Kanye West album is the same week we get a Drake album, which is so funny to me, and I don't even want to get into the beef of all of that. But I will say, one, I'm excited to hear this because it looks like it's all new music. It was so smart for Drake to have the billboards the way he did. This album is 1 hour and 23 minutes. I already got on Donda for being as long as it was, and I don't even want to get into that. But Drake, can you make your albums an hour? Because this is going to take longer for me to edit, but, you know, it's okay. I have no idea what to expect except either Drake going in on his raps, Drake making some R&B cuts, Drake being a simp, Drake being cocky with his stardom and his star power, and maybe even subliminal disses. I don't know, but you know what? I'm not going to waste any more time. I'm just going to jump straight into this album, Certified Lover Boy by Drake. First track is Champagne Poetry. I feel like I've heard this sample before.
I've been hot since the birth of my son. I remain unfazed, trust words has been.
You were hotter before that. Boys.
And nothing tell the truth like the eyes will. Live so much for others don't True. Remember. You niggas gassed up, you couldn't pay the.
The gas bill?
Yeah.
Okay, V-Chain.
Man, I can't even RIP and show my remorse to the homie. No, I carry the guilt to the sin. My therapist's voice is making the choices for me. And I always.
Let's type it up. That was poetry. The sound effect sounds like Goku's about to pop up. Kind of like how Drake was introspective on that being the height of his career, but then also being a co-parent, but then also talking about, like, you know, and it's probably still something he's always kind of thought about even as a kid, the whole idea of his parents' divorce. I like that he brought up mentioning something about therapy, which, I mean, I feel like his time is moving forward, and I don't even want to make it so much about black men, but just in general, I love that rappers are mentioning therapy, you know, like, you know, men can see a therapist and, you know, it's all right. And it's not new ground, but for Drake, it, I guess, kind of is. His music has, to me, always been like, I guess, from a bird's eye view, his form of therapy and him just expressing how he feels. But, you know, that's, music is only for a few minutes that you can do that. For me, his intro tracks are some of my favorites. Let's get on with the next track, Poppy's Home. Drake, why did you name it that?
Don't worry.
Poppy's Home.
Daddy's Home.
Okay.
Let's turn it up.
That's Nikki. That's Nikki. At this point, I start collecting shots.
Daddy's home.
Yeah. Daddy's home. Woo. Okay, yeah, I didn't mean to wild out like that, but I had to. That beat was too fire. It would have been interesting to have Nikki rap on it. I don't know why they just had her talk, but whatever. I don't really have too much to say because I was just more impressed with the beat itself, so that's my bad. So I'm gonna have to go back to that track after this video. Let's get on with the next track, Girls Want Girls featuring Lil Baby.
Say that you a lesbian girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls,
I understand all intent and purpose of the song, but my main point is, one, him making this song kind of reminds me of that one line from, I'm forgetting the name of the track, it's on Carter Ford by Lil Wayne. And it has Jadakiss and Drake on it. Forgetting the song name, but it doesn't matter because I'll put it up right here. But it reminds me of this line that Lil Wayne did say with Drake saying, oh, she says I'm a lesbian. Yeah, me too. That's what it kind of reminds me of. But then at the same time, both him and Baby didn't really say anything that really caught my ear to be like, oh, I want to hear that again. That's definitely for the late night type vibe. Let's get on with the next track, In the Bible, which that's ironic because Donda just came out, featuring Lil Durk and Giveon.
You don't know love, you don't love me like my child. Lay your ass down. I did my dance one time on TikTok and went viral with it.
When you see the real, will you still want me? I actually like Lil Durk on the track. Giveon is in his bag this year when it comes to features. I mean, of course, I'm thinking about Peaches, but he also took over this song, and I mean that in a good way. Solid track. Let's get on with the next track, and I've been excited for this because, of course, he said the GOAT is on this project when he put up the billboard in New York. Who else could he have been talking about? Hove, Jigga, Jay-Z.
Build foundation. Never had a lot. This is all I need. But call me for songs or they call me for paper.
I know where the fuck you live. Niggas gotta chill with talking gangster. You should just thank us. I'm back and forth on the internet. Nigga, we don't tennis that. Y'all gotta do something.
When it comes to Drake and Jay-Z making songs together, this is like, what, their fifth song? This might be my second favorite. I like seeing these two collab. I don't think they should make an album together, but when it comes to Jay-Z being on Drake's albums, he kind of compliments the track that he's on more times if not. To, I don't know if this is a hot take, he ends up having the best verse anyway. I love that both of them kind of talked about the themes of people that they're close to, wanting love, but then they're actually wanting to envy, hate, turn their back against you. I love that theme of that, especially with that whole saying of keep your friends close, but keep your enemies closer. That's basically what they're talking about. You know, with the next track, Fair Trades, features Travis Scott. Kind of similar to Drake and Jay-Z working together. When Travis Scott and Drake work together, it actually ends up turning pretty well. Not like I had any high hopes of, oh, this is gonna be the best song, but let's face it, whether it was Travis being on If You're Reading This, More Life, Drake being on Astroworld, their collabs, it actually ends up being pretty good. Let's get on with the next track. Oh my god, Way Too Sexy. This features Future and Young Thug. Of course, you make this the sample.
Too sexy for this world. Got too sexy for that metro house. You a turd, a little thotty. Ain't no wife about it. Don't know where I went. Where I can pay for my dogs. I might nick. Young nigga have a mouth. She don't make sure the car gets too sexy, sexy for the trap.
You know what? Yeah, not bad. I think Future was the best part of the song. Kind of made it his own song when you think about it. Let's get on with the next track, TSU.
What's up to all the ladies on the north side?
My mama is not around. I like to climb on the top of the pole. You used to do pornos when you would come over, but now you got more of the shit.
Okay.
Hey.
Okay.
Black boxes with the bone rolls.
I'm not saying I hate the track. What I'm saying is I probably won't play that track unless I'm playing the album. Drake is making songs for the strip club, like, he can definitely do that. And if he's having a crush on a stripper, wasn't there a point though where he was trying to get girls out the strip club? That's funny, but I do like the song in terms of like how it, you know, sounded. But I personally just wouldn't return to that track. Let's get on with the next track, In Too Deep, features once again Future.
Like then, and you know how it goes when I see you. I was.
Why was this not the beat? Look, I wasn't trying to be petty in that first half, but I'm sorry. Like, I'm all for Drake making slow jams and, like I said, that late night vibe. But don't make the instrumental boring. That, I'm sorry, like, I mean, maybe because the beat had to build up. And it was one of those tracks where the beat just had to build up. So I get that. I love the second half way more. I love Future's verse. I've, you know, said it already. Future kind of takes over. Although, this time around, Drake was on the hook. Let's go on with the next track, Pipe Down.
And when you see Chanel, I wish that's how you saw me. That shit you tell. How much I gotta spend for you to pipe down.
Yeah, I've heard that before. Yeah, that track just also kind of isn't for me. I don't know what you want me to say. Let's get on with the next track, Yiba's Heartbreak.
Well, I'll make it up to you. All and all that you are, I do.
I like that track. It kind of reminds me of when Drake had Kendrick Lamar on the Bird Alive interlude, just letting the artists have their own track. That was beautiful. Just gotta say it was beautiful. The next track is No Friends in This Industry.
Yeah, no friends in the industry. My brother's
yeah,
been my
this
brother's
is, this is what I need.
No friends in the industry. I had to draw the line between my brothers and my.
Sampling 3-6.
Yeah, bro. And I'm like
Shakari, smoke a moaning
of the chat. Hey, and you know Shakari? I've been doing this for a long time. Yeah. Now them cheats, now them posts. Ain't got the type of time.
Yo, wait. Was he dissing Kanye? Makes me wonder. That's what I'm talking about. And hey, I'm not somebody that hates when Drake sings. I love when Drake raps, and that was what I needed. And I'm probably reaching with the sneak diss, with the whole tweets and everything, but I'm just saying, when Drake brings that type of energy, that makes me happy that I've been listening to him for so long. Let's go on with the next track, Knife Talk, featuring 21 Savage and Project Pat.
Let the chopper bang on you like a blood or a cripper.
Chopper hit him and he turned into a booty clapper. Smith and Wesson.
Loving the two-track run once again. Let's see what this track is. 7 a.m. on Brittle Path.
Could at least keep it a buck like Anthony Tacumbo. I made north of the border like Vito Rizzuto. Only tea you getting from me is one for the walk of shame. Get that address to your driver, make it your destination. Instead of just a post out of desperation. This means you the deep you over there trying to impress the nation. Minds running wild with the speculation.
Whenever Drake has a song that has a timestamp, like 4 p.m. in Calabasas, I think 4 p.m. in New York, I end up loving that track. I love this track. I feel like he's dissing Kanye. Even the whole, oh, go ahead and post that address. Like, I'm thinking he's talking to Ye. Let's see what this track is like. Race My Mind. You can make R&B, Drake, especially with a beat like this.
How supposed to wife it? You not Aisha enough. You love getting teed up. Love showing it.
I don't really have to say much more than just I like when Drake makes tracks like that. Like he can make R&B singing tracks all he wants to, like as long as it keeps my interest, and that's fine. But some of the earlier tracks, not so much. Let's go on with the next track, Fountains. This features Tems. Is it really a Drake album if you don't have a dancehall track on it? Honest truth, I'm indifferent towards that track. I listened to a few dancehall Afrobeat artists, Burna Boy, Wizkid. I'm gonna add that to the dancehall playlist that I do have. I don't know how often I'm gonna personally want to return to that track. That's not even saying it in a bad way, it's just me saying, like, I don't know how often I'll just go back to it. I don't hate the track. Get on with the next track, Get Along Better. This features Ty Dolla $ign.
Based on the scene, you said I was too invested in.
He hit that falsetto. He
hit.
There's Ty Dolla $ign. The idea of that's kind of funny to me, but I love how Drake and Ty Dolla $ign, I guess, kind of went about it. Let's go on with the next track, You Only Live Twice. What Happened to YOLO? This features Lil Wayne and Rick Ross. Okay.
Not sure if you know, but I'm actually Michael Jackson. The man I see in the mirror
what?
Is actually going to sound like a bitch. You fancy, huh? I had to fuck a lot of girls to get a kid like this. I had to get a lot of cribs to get a Ben Spazzins and CB was chunking up the deuces, niggas, nigga.
Oh, yeah. The deuces. For some reason, my camera decided to not record the rest of my reaction to the track, but Wayne killed it, Ross killed it, Drake, yeah, he killed it too. Here's me reacting to the next track, I Miss You Too, featuring Kid Cudi, who I never thought I would see work with Drake ever. It's just because of their beef. That might be my favorite track. I'm not just saying, nah, who am I kidding? I'm saying it because, yes, I love Cudi, but God, I never thought Drake and Kanye would ever make a song. I would knew one day if they ever made a song, even when I was a kid playing their music, both their albums, that if they ever decided to make a track, it would probably sound good. Because Drew beats old, and y'all can say what you want. Kanye's actually pretty versatile. We know Drake's versatile. You know, he's more versatile than potatoes. So, of course, anytime he works with anybody, it kind of just works. This is the track I was fearing. Track 20, fucking fans.
You sit in a house and I'll be out.
To 20s and I still want to party. I cannot be trusted on my own with nobody.
Dude, that song works for the theme of the whole certified lover boy idea. All I'm saying is, though, why should I care if you with somebody but you was too busy fucking the fans? I'm sure when I play the album, I'm not gonna want to skip it. So who am I kidding? I don't hate that track. I guess it's not as bad as I thought it would be. I thought it was gonna be more of a bragging thing. Get on with the final track, The Remorse.
Damon College booking me to pull up and speak the facts. Even if they make a movie about us, then there is no salary cap, there is no paying them back. Anxiety's a drug that I use to get the job done. Delusional's a space. My son is the one thing I hate to be apart from. Bet against me, don't know where they get. I can't even hear myself when I get quiet time. Like how they telling me I'm done when I'm in my prime.
That's deep.
You comparing it to what I really made off. Like Bernie with all the earnings that they came off.
Trust. That song for this album is how the ride was for Take Care. Drake. This is typically how it goes whenever I react to music, even though I don't really do that too much anymore. But I mean, let me just say this in terms of what I love about this album. What I love is it's Drake still staying in like that familiar territory of what he's always just kind of done, but doing it where it does have a nice fresh sound to it. Said what I needed to say on the R&B aspect of Drake, but it does have that R&B aspect of Drake. It even has the dance hall just for a little bit. Wouldn't be a Drake album if he didn't do that, but that kind of goes back to what I'm saying of for Drake anytime, and that's just what it's going to be with me and probably his music for the rest of his career. It is kind of the same old, what Drake has done whenever he makes an album. And I love how it starts out. I love the songs where it had like a nice few track runs. Way Too Sexy ended up being better than I thought it was going to be. No Friends in the Industry, I know he was talking about Ye. And from tracks 13 to 19, actually 11 to 19, I'm going to let Fountains be in that little nice track run. That's where I love Drake as an artist and being able to be versatile. The issue that I have with this album is some of the songs either are songs that Drake has kind of already made before, or better yet, there's songs on here like Girls Want Girls featuring Lil Baby. Gimme Wants and Needs, I would take that over Girls Want Girls. I just didn't really care for that track. I didn't really care for Pipe Down. I didn't love In Too Deep until the second half. These are just songs that I personally didn't mess with on first listen. Definitely gotta give this album a couple more spins before I have like a final opinion. Drake says a lot on here when it comes to the rap songs, when it comes to the diss tracks, when it comes to just him, you know, defending his character, being a dad, things like that. Even in the outro, The Remorse, he knows what he's doing, and whether he has writers or whatnot, I could care less about that. This was, to me, a nice listen. I don't know if it's like album of the year contender worthy, but in terms of just some of these songs in here, there's songs that I'm probably going to play for a minute. I definitely prefer this over Scorpion, though, okay? I think Scorpion was like that one album of Drake where I'm just like, okay, side B didn't need to be a thing. Do you think it was worth the wait? How do y'all feel about Certified Lover Boy? Whatever you think, please let me know in the comments down below. Please like this video. Thank y'all so much for watching. As always, y'all are the best. Look forward to more of that coming soon. Until next time, I'll see y'all later.